Welcome to my channel. I Neel ma'am here. Today I'm going to teach you history chapter number 3, the Delhi Sultans. Today our topic is the Delhi Sultans. Today we will learn about the rulers of Delhi and sources about the Delhi Sultans. Circle of Justice in video number 1 of chapter number 3, the Delhi Sultans. Here in this chapter you will learn about the sources of Delhi Sultans. Inscriptions, coins and architectures provide a lot of information. Valuable history is called Tariq. Tell us about the Delhi Sultans. Histories were written in by authors who were learned men, एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर्स, पोइट्स एंड कोर्टियर्स होते हैं जो दरबारी होते हैं. दीज ऑथर्स एडवाइस द रूलर्स टू मेंटेन एन आइडियल सोशल ऑर्डर. देन यू विल टूडे लर्न अबाउट द सर्कल ऑफ जस्टिस. ए किंग कांट सर्वाइव विदाउट सोल्जर्स. सोल्जर्स कांट लिव विदाउट सैलरीज. सैलरीज कम फ्रॉम द रेवेन्यू और टैक्सेस कलेक्टेड फ्रॉम पीजेंट्स. Peasants pay revenue when they are happy. This happens when the king promotes justice and safety. So, in chapter number 2, you saw that the regions like the Kaveri Delta became the center of large kingdoms. Did you notice that there was no mention of a kingdom with Delhi as its capital? No, na? Only there Kaveri became the center of large kingdoms. That was because Delhi became an important city only in the 12th century. Take a look at table number 1. Here, table number 1, the rulers of Delhi. Delhi first became the capital of a kingdom under the Tomra Rajputs, who were defeated in the middle of 12th century by the Chauhans, also referred to as Chahamnas of Ajmer. It was under the Tomras and Chauhanas that Delhi became an important commercial center. Many rich Jaina merchants lived in the city and constructed several temples. Coin minted here, sikke yahan par dhale jate the, sikko ki taksal thi, called sikke jisko kya bolte the, Delhi wall. Coin minted here called Delhi wall had a wide circulation. The transformation of Delhi into a capital that controlled vast areas of the subcontinent started with the foundation of the Delhi Sultanate in the beginning of the 13th century. Take a look at table number 1 again and identify the 5 dynasties that together made the Delhi Sultanate. The Delhi Sultans built many cities in the area that we know here, that we know as Delhi. Look at map number 1 and locate Delhi, A Kunha, Siri and Jahanpana. Delhi, you will look at map number here. This is map number 1 and locate Delhi, A Kunha, Siri and Jahanpana. Here Delhi Kunha is here in this map. Here it is Jahanpana and this is Siri located here. Now come to here table number 1. There it is about the rulers of Delhi. as you know, Delhi became an important city only in the 12th century. Delhi first became the capital of the Indian kingdom under the Tomra Rajputs. First of all, Delhi became the capital of the Indian kingdom under the Tomra Rajputs. And king was Anangapala. He ruled from 1130 to 1145. The transformation of Delhi started with the foundation of Delhi Sultanate. Then there was rule of Chauhans. They ruled from 1165 to 1192. Prithviraj Chauhan ruled from 1175 to 1192. Then there was rule of early Turkish rulers, Kutubuddin Ayubek. He ruled from 1206 to 1210. Then Shamsuddin Iltutmish, he ruled from 1210 to 1236. Razia Sultana, she ruled in 1236 to 1240. Then there was rule of Ghiyasuddin Balban. He ruled from 1266 to 1287. This picture is of Iltutmish tomb. Then there was rule of Khalji dynasty. Jalaluddin Khilji, he ruled from 1290 to 1296. Then there was rule of Alauddin Khilji. He ruled from 1296 to 1316. Then there was rule of Tughlaq dynasty. Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq, he ruled from 1320 to 1324. Muhammad Tughlaq, he ruled from 1324 to 1351. Firoz Shah Tughlaq, he also ruled from 1351 to 1388. Then there was rule of Sayyid dynasty. Khizr Khan of Sayyid dynasty, he ruled from 1414 to 1421. Then there was rule of Lodi dynasty in Delhi. Behlol Lodi, he ruled from 1451 to 1489. So you will learn that the transformation of Delhi started with the foundation of the Delhi Sultanate. Inscription, coins, architecture and Tawarikh provide a lot of information about the Delhi Sultanate. Persian was the language of the administration under the Delhi Sultans. In 1236, Iltutmish's daughter Razia became the Sultan but was dethroned in 1240 as nobles were not happy at having a queen as ruler. Finding out about the Delhi Sultans. Although inscriptions, coins and architecture provide a lot of information, especially valuable are histories, Tarikh singular, Tawarikh we call it in plural form. Written in Persian, the language of administration under the Delhi Sultans. The authors of Tawarikh were learned men, secretaries, administrators, poets and courtiers who both recounted events and advised rulers on governance, emphasizing the importance of just rule. There were four stages, this picture here, four stages in the making of a manuscript. In picture A, preparing the paper. in B, writing the text, in C, melting gold to highlight important words and passages, in D, preparing the binding. Then come the circle of justice. Fakhre Mudabbir wrote in the 13th century, a king can't survive without soldiers, and soldiers can't live without salaries. Salaries come from the revenue collected from peasants, but peasants can pay revenue only when they are prosperous and happy. This happens when the king promotes justice and honest governance. जब राजा उचित न्याय करेगा तभी जो किसान होंगे वो खुशहाल होंगे और खुश होंगे, तभी वो टैक्स दे पाएंगे. जब राजा प्रमोट करेगा जस्टिस और ऑनेस्ट गवर्नेंस. डू यू थिंक द सर्कल ऑफ जस्टिस इज एन अप्रोप्रिएट टर्म टू डिस्क्राइब द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द किंग एंड हिज सब्जेक्ट्स? यस, द सर्कल ऑफ जस्टिस इज एन अप्रोप्रिएट टर्म टू डिस्क्राइब द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द किंग एंड हिज सब्जेक्ट्स. सब्जेक्ट्स मीन्स उसके जो राजा के सेवक हैं, सब्जेक्ट्स उसको प्रजा को भी बोलते हैं. एंड व्हेन वी कैन से कि द सर्कल ऑफ जस्टिस इज एन अप्रोप्रिएट टर्म टू डिस्क्राइब द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द किंग एंड हिज सब्जेक्ट्स. कीप द फॉलोइंग एडिशनल डिटेल्स इन माइंड. The authors of Tawarikh lived in cities, mainly Delhi, and hardly ever in villages. They often wrote their histories for sultans in the hope of rich rewards. These authors advised rulers on the need to preserve an ideal social order based on birthright. Birthright, it is the privileges claimed on account of birth. For example, people believed that nobles inherited their rights to govern because they were born in certain families. कि जो गवर्नेंस की जो पोस्ट थी वो हेरिडिटरी थी, कि कुछ नॉबल्स ये सोचते थे कि ये हमारा बर्थ राइट अधिकार है, जो भी है हमारा ये जन्म से ये अधिकार है कि अगर हमारे जो ग्रैंडफादर थे या फादर थे वो गवर्नेंस की पोस्ट में तो उनको भी उनके बाद वो पोस्ट मिलनी चाहिए. सो सोशल ऑर्डर बेस्ड ऑन बर्थ राइट एंड जेंडर डिस्टिंक्शंस. Gender distinctions mean social and biological differences between women and men. Usually these differences are used to argue that men are superior to women. तो तब ये सोचा जाता था कि जो men हैं वो women से superior हैं. In 1236, Sultan Iltutmish's daughter Razia became Sultan. The chronicler of the age, Minhaj-e Siraj, recognized that she was more able and qualified than all her brothers, but he was not comfortable at having a queen as ruler. Nor were the nobles happy at her attempts to rule independently. She was removed from the throne in 1240. तो जो कौन था मिन्हाजल सिराज, कौन था ये? ये था मिन्हाजे सिराज जुजानी, फुल नेम. ही वॉज ए 13th सेंचुरी पर्शियन हिस्टोरियन बॉर्न इन गौर प्रोविंस इन 1227. जुजानी माइग्रेटेड टू उच देन टू दिल्ली. ही वॉज अ प्रिंसिपल हिस्टोरियन फॉर मामलुक सल्तनत ऑफ दिल्ली इन 13th सेंचुरी. ही वॉज बॉर्न इन फिरोज कुच मॉडर्न डे अफगानिस्तान एंड डाइड इन दिल्ली. ही वॉज ऑल्सो ए क्वाजी ऑफ दिल्ली एंड ग्वालियर. हिज अदर नेम वॉज अबू उस्मान मिन्हाजुद्दीन बिन सिराजुद्दीन। सो ही ऑर्गेनाइज दैट रजिया सुल्ताना वॉज मोर एबल एंड क्वालिफाइड दैन ऑल हर ब्रदर्स, बट शी वॉज नॉट कम्फर्टेबल एट हैविंग ए क्वीन एज रूलर, नॉर वर द नॉबल्स हैप्पी एट हर अटेम्प्ट टू रूल इंडिपेंडेंटली। दैट्स वाई शी वॉज रिमूव फ्रॉम द थ्रोन इन 1240। सो वट वॉज मिन्हाजे सिराज थॉट अबाउट रजिया? मिन्हाजे सिराज थॉट दैट क्वींस रूल वेंट अगेंस्ट द आइडियल सोशल ऑर्डर क्रिएटेड बाई गॉड, इन विच वुमेन वर सपोज टू बी सबॉर्डिनेट टू मैन। हेयर सबॉर्डिनेट मीनिंग कि वुमेन आर लोअर इन रैंक और पोजिशन, और वी कैन से कि ट्रीट एज ऑफ लेसर इम्पोर्टेंस दैन मैन, मीनिंग ऑफ सबॉर्डिनेट। सो इन विच वुमेन वर सपोज टू बी सबॉर्डिनेट मीन्स लोअर इन रैंक और पोजिशन टू मैन। ही देयर फोर आस्ट इन द रजिस्टर ऑफ गॉड्स क्रिएशन, सिंस हर अकाउंट डिड नॉट फॉल अंडर द कॉलम ऑफ मैन। How did she gain from all her excellent qualities? On her inscriptions and coins, Razia mentioned that she was the daughter of Sultan Iltumish. This was a contrast to the Queen Rudrama Devi, 1262 to 1289 of the Kakatiya dynasty of Warangal, part of modern Andhra Pradesh. Rudrama Devi changed her name on her inscription and pretended she was a man. Another queen, Didha, ruled in Kashmir 980 to 1003. Her title is interesting. It comes from Didi, or elder sister, and obviously affectionate term given to a loved ruler by her subjects. So express Minhaj ideas in your own words. Do you think Razia shared these ideas? Why do you think it was so difficult for a woman to be a ruler? According to Minhaj Siraj, God has created a social order in which woman is subordinate to man. The woman is lower in rank or position to man. Therefore, a woman like Rajia does not have right to rule. This was thinking of Minhaj-e Siraj, who was a Persian historian. Therefore, a woman like Rajia does not have right to rule. It was totally against the idea here. It was totally against the idea social order created by God. I think Razia did not share these ideas. It was very difficult for women to be a ruler because of her belonging to a subordinate gender according to the social setup at that time. So you, whatever is taught, you will revise today. So stay alert, stay healthy. This is part one of chapter number 3 of your history book, The Delhi Sultans. Try to learn important years or periods about rulers of Delhi. Till then, stay alert, stay healthy, mask yourself, take proper care. Thank you. Have a nice day. God bless you.